Theodora Leonti, and today we'll be painting Starry Night by Van Gogh. So there it is. This is what I did yesterday for our Amazon Live. So this is what we're going to recreate today. We will be using some gouache and some watercolors. So here I have the Art Nomen from Zen Art Supplies. It's a new product. I really like this one. It's one of my favorite zip ones. So it has a very smart design, so if you open it, so here you flip it and you have like all your brushes, and under is your paint and a sponge, and you have like this mixing area. So it has this really smart design and I really love it, and it has some really good pigmentation. So I'm just going to flip my camera around so we can start painting. Mine has been a bit difficult, but still good. Okay. All right, so now our water is clean. And let's grab our tape. Yeah, that's quite true. That's true. No matter how big something seems at the time, it always comes to pass, so yeah, that's true. So let's start with the wash. Just going to use some blues from this palette, which is the Art Nomad. So we're going to use this blue shade. I think it's perfect for the sky. For our Starry Night. So let's do some washes. So use a brush that is round, preferably, for this. You see that this palette has some beautiful color pigments. It's very pigmented. It's a professional quality palette. The Art Nomad, like I said. Perfect. So we have our first layer here. Use some of it for this area. And what I really like about this paint is that you can thin them down with water as much as you want, and you can get a more transparent result. But if you want them also, you can use them with less water and you can see how pigmented they are. I'm going to use my hair dryer real quick. Okay. So don't forget to tell me, guys, who is your favorite painter? Or what is your favorite painting, for instance? You might also like Starry Night by Van Gogh. I think everyone really likes his work. I haven't heard of someone saying that he's overrated or that he doesn't like his work. So I think he's like everyone's favorite. Even though while he was still alive, he might have felt like people didn't care much about his paintings, since I think he've only sold one in his lifetime, so he probably didn't know how loved his art would be later on. And I think that's a little sad, because he might have felt like he's a failure. So yeah, I feel sad sympathy towards him. Perfect. Hi, Narita. Yes, they were really something else. It's beautiful movement. So let's use our hair dryer again. Yeah, that's quite true. It was a bit difficult to make a name back in the day, even though he did share his work with his brother, who was an art dealer of sorts. He didn't really promote him, and that's, I don't understand why, to be honest. But yeah, now things are more easy, I think. In a way, yes. Okay, so we are going to lay down our base colors. And then we're going to start working on all the details. Really? Okay, well, Picasso is a different story. I don't like his painting style, but he was like a talented artist. I mean, he could paint very well classically if he wanted to, but he wanted to do something that no other artist has done at the time, I guess. So he was sort of a pioneer, so that's something I respect. But yeah, I can tell you that I love his aesthetic, but his painting, Guernica, is really something else, you know. It's one of his paintings that I think are worthy to admire. In my opinion, yes. So we're going to add a little bit of this green down here as well. And now we're going to lay all the details on top since we have a base color underneath. Some painting, but you can also discuss.
Perfect.
Okay. Okay, so now I'm going to mix some colors for our background. Perfect. So it will be like so I think I'll be starting from the white swirls we have in the back. So let's start from there. So this is some white gouache. Okay. So we're working on the sky first a little bit. We work with small brushes. strokes, giving a little bit of sense of direction and movement. Also, if you would like to guys participate to our challenges, you can check out all the instructions. We have pinned this post here on the group, so you can check them out. And I think it's just a bit to miss out on this because everyone wins. Like you share your work here, that is, for instance, this month is about something summary. So you paint something summary basically, and then you use a hashtag, and you will get a discount on your next order with Sonat supplies. And they don't usually give any discounts, so yeah, that's a good offer, I think. Right now I'm using the black tulip brush. It's one of their bestseller sets. This and the following ninja brushes are quite popular and they disappear often, so this is are the brushes I also recommend, no matter your level. Okay, so this is very meditating in a way, because you paint some small brush strokes, but they all give movement and they connect with each other. And it's quite relaxing, and I think that's what Van Gogh felt painting on this brushstrokes. I think it must have been really good for his soul. It must have been like his form of meditation for sure. And it's something that I do suggest you guys do in order to relax. You should give this a try. I think you're gonna like it. So automatically, as you can see, we have like some sense of movement going on in the background now. Okay. And also I'm adding a little bit of this blue here just to give the impression that you can see through. That it blends a little bit with the background, but not really. Perfect. Now we're going to add the yellow stars and give some color. So that things aren't so monochromatic. Again, you know, you just touch your brush around, just give some small marks here and there. So I just switch brush because I felt like this is like too big. So these are like our stars. Right here. Perfect. So you can see that this is really relaxing and easy to do. We're going to add a bit of highlights, of course. We have still to add detail. Alright. Let's add another one here. Alright. Well, thank you, Narita. The circles in the background? Yeah. Those are stars, and we have some swirls. I think the swirls are like the wind or something like that. And we're going to add some detail there as well. But we're taking it a step at a time. And that's the way that the image comes together, little by little. And we're using both gouache and watercolor. So in order to recap, we have a base of watercolor under, so it won't be transparent when we start laying colors, and that helps because we don't start with like white. It's easier when you have some color already down to build it up from there. And then on top we lay some gouache. Because I think for the subs that we're painting today, for this one, it will come, the result would be much better with a gouache. You can also try with acrylics as well. It's going to give you so much texture. I think it's going to look really good with acrylics as well. Doing some corrections there because I'm fixing the shape of this tree. All right. I just need some thicker paint. Fix the shape. Perfect. Okay. So now we need some ochre. Some texture to build it up there, the detail. So it's easier if you lay the darkest color on the bottom and then you can put on all your highlights. It will really make them pop. Alright, so let's add some more details at the bottom. So we also have some green there. Also, if you do have like our products and you love them, don't forget to use the hashtag ZenArtSupplies on Instagram. And you might get featured on social media, so more people will see your beautiful creations. And of course, we will be able to see them, so that's nice. That's something that really makes us happy, to see people being happy with their orders, so that's pretty important. So we're creating textures, we're adding different sides of green there, and that really helps with depth and texture as well. It's pretty important. Okay, so let's add some detail here as well. Small brush strokes. And then some white. And some yellow ochre. And of course, if you recreate that, don't forget to post it here on our Facebook group Inspiration Daily so we can see it. I would love to see your creations. Let's put some white here. Also help us with the movement. And since we still have the white, let's add some detail here as well, some highlights. And now I just realized we forgot to put the star here, so I'm just going to add it now. I think it's going to look so much nicer with the star. Let's add some white brush strokes. Here as well. So yeah, Van Gogh was like all about those brush strokes. All right, I think it looks much nicer now. I'm going to add a bit more here just to blend it a bit with the background. A bit more detail here. So this is like a hazel sage because we added some yellow ochre to our green. Small brush strokes, that's sticky like you said. Maybe I need a little bit more of this dark green. Just here, just a bit. Just a hint. Maybe this is too light. Just to give a bit of shape. All right. So yeah, that's it for today. So this is how we have recreated again the Van Gogh